morning, everyone, and welcome to DelCast Gaming. This is Eric, your host, with Final Fantasy XIV Roll Reborn. And as you can see, I'm already in the snow level. If you were watching me last night on Twitch, you noticed that I wasn't on there on the stream. I was playing. Remote play from my phone. I just wanted to relax with the family. That's why I did that, but I'm back now. I'm only going to be playing for about an hour and a half, and then I'm going to go outside and do some work outside. But this morning I just wanted to do a little bit of running through here, trying to get a little bit further into the game. As you can see, I did get my my armor last night for the paladin. I don't have my weapon yet, but that'll come later. But I did make it look like a little cooler. This I like the shield, so I left it alone, but the sword I changed because the sword looked kind of weird. I didn't like that kind of sword. So without further ado, let's go ahead and continue. I'm at level 50. I just finished that job quest. I finished the job quest for the entire game, so the job's done. Now I have to travel. Make sure I get these eggs activated. And I'll upload. Oh, let me do my checkover right now. Well, just once should be enough. Alright, so. Yep, let's go ahead and head on out. That music came a little late, didn't it? Just trying to see which way to go. Here, gotta come down. Yeah, gotta come down, okay. Should be a little area to turn over here. Hard to tell sometimes. Wait. Yeah, that's the right direction. I've been here before. I was fighting that salamander thing right here. But I'm coming in from south, so last time I came from the east to the west. Let's continue forward. Not even gonna worry about any of these little enemies through here. Just trying to get to the story quest. That is all. I'll go to this little building. Okay, that's cool. Talk to Sid. Where are we heading? Century Castrum. Oh no, this is the Revenant Toll. Okay, so what's the easiest way to get there? Let me see. Been here yet? I have. Okay, Ardona's this direction. Oh. Dang it. Go. Cortus. So, is that on this? It's from this map. Okay, so we're gonna travel. So yeah, definitely coming into the end of the game right now. I'm going to Mordona. Mordona is like the last pieces of land before you before you head into Heaven's Ward. But there's a lot of story before that happens. But because I defeated but since I finished the job quest at level 50, that's as high as you can go until you get into Heaven's Ward. At Heaven's Ward, though, I'm gonna change my job, obviously. If you've been following me long enough, you know that Dark Knight is probably my most favorite job out of all the jobs I've played. So, yeah. Come this direction here. Made it here. Alright. This is where you can collect your end weapons and gear right here. If y'all wanna know. Y'all just following me for the first time. Gotta hit this aetherite real quick. To Glowmont then. Thank you. if I got any dungeons that I haven't done yet. Done that one, done that one. So the Wanderer's Place is the only one I haven't done yet. Oh, I need an average level of 45. What do I have? 40. Okay, so I'll have to upgrade my weapon, my gear to fight in that dungeon. So I'll probably have to wait. Do I have any money? Any of those things? No, I don't have any. Dang it. Okay. That's fine. Let's see. Where are we heading to next? Right there. Okay. And there's some things I gotta do over here. Go ahead and get all these blue button things. These are very important, or, well, I say very important, they're important. It's only one right now, so let's go ahead and get that one done. Any more on the map? Okay, let's do the Simply to Die For thing. Gear from here. Oh, this is all the gear I have already, so never mind. If I ever become level 50, I can collect my gear from there. I'm guessing that's what that is. Alright, so how do I get down there? Okay, so I gotta go downwards. Okay. This is a little bit of an aggravating area sometimes, so I gotta be on my toes for this. Hopefully I don't think I've died yet playing this these episodes, so that's good. Oh, that's just my thought. If I did, I don't remember. I don't think I've died so far. These toes will grab you and pull them towards yourselves, towards themselves, and avoid them. I mean, you can kill them, they're level 44. I used to grind for them for their skin or something. It was really expensive, and I used to make a lot of money that way. But they're not like that anymore. A lot of people make it now, so it's not worth grinding anymore. This guy's fishing. But this is the area I need to go through. I hate these chocobos, or not chocobos, these Marlboros. That button does. Renders you impervious to most attacks. That would be good to have somewhere else though. Right there, good. Okay. Yeah, I will move that over in a minute. I've been using the other button in a different spot, so. Excuse me, guys. Sorry, my nose was giving me issues there. Is he over there? But he's still sitting over there. Level 46, so let's do one at a time. This person first, so this job first. to our west. These are the clusters, I believe. There's one up here as well. There it is. Guys, hopefully I don't get grabbed by one of these guys. They like to lick on you and stick and pull you towards themselves, so I'm trying to avoid that as much as possible. Salamanders aren't very good either. They're not as bad as the toads though. Them. both are in the same area, similar area. Careful with these toads. Thank you. Alright, so just repairing the gear that I just picked up from those Imperial soldiers. So I gotta put that gear on, I guess. I think it's one of these. Yep. I think a helmet. Yep. I don't think there's anything else, though. That's all I need. There's no music in Mordona, like in the outskirts.
Thank you.
Oh, I missed the spot. That's up there. Okay. plenty of money, little guy. Travel to Ulda. Use some money to get some stuff for the Magitech. Thank you. There we go. That's better. Let's see if I can get these guys. Hopefully we'll be able to defeat these chokers. This mechanical set. in my suit just in case. Let's go get them.
Intrigues us. We desire only to understand it, and for that we need your help. You wish to be rid of the icons, do you not? You would have saved yourself a great deal of torment had you accepted our aid from the beginning. Everything, and I shall end it quickly. Refuse, and though you beg for death, you shall not have it. Which will it be? As you wish, my dear Minfilia. Unpleasant though it will be for all concerned, you leave us no choice but to employ more rigorous methods of study. Be so kind as to deliver the prisoners to Castrum Meridianum.
Yes, milady.
Sad. This messed up. Pieces of crap. Alright, I'm here. Okay. Thank you. What happened? Is that code? Hello? Y'all okay? Yeah. What's wrong? Okay, yeah, I'm almost done.
Kill the rest. You ditched your Magitech armor. Fool of a Lalafell.
Well, excuse me. She's all yours if you think you can do any better.
Which is more pitiful, the charlatans who rule Eorzea, or the masses that clamor for their implausible panaceas? I see that which they cannot. This realm founders for want of a ruler with true power, the power to cast down icons. If you continue to deny this truth, it is the people who will suffer. Embrace reason. What in the seven hells? Oh no, it's here.
12 preservers. They finished it. Ultima weapon.
So it has a name.
It is a relic of ancient Alag, excavated from its resting place deep beneath Alamigo. The Alagans used it to crush primal and foe alike. And now the Galleons mean to do the same.
Damn you, Gaius! Look! There, beside the Black Wolf! An Ascian! An overlord, no less. His garb attests to that.
La Habrea! It could only be him. He was La Habrea? No. No, this cannot be.
We have to go now.
Thancred! No!
Ha 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 ha
All that time, the enemy was beside me, and I never even suspected. And to think that it was I who suggested that Thancred investigate the Ascians. How could I have been so blind? Small wonder the enemy knew our every move, and where to find us. Confound it all! No. No, this is not the time for self-doubt. The Alliance leaders staked their hopes on the Scions, but now they believe us all dead or missing. When they learn of the Empire's new weapon, we cannot be certain what they will do. We must go and offer them what assurances we can that defeat is not inevitable.
Kryl, this is Minfilia.
The situation may have taken an ill turn.
Forgive me if I seem brusque.
But the battle is far from over. And so long as we stand together, there shall ever be hope of victory.
I'm sorry to press, but we need it urgently.
The people of Eorzea falter for want of such hope. Let us provide it.
I am in your debt.
Let us bear to them the tidings that the Scions of the Seventh Dawn are returned. Matters are coming to a head. I hope we can count on you.
My regards to Grandfather. I am ready. Let us pay a visit to the Council of the Alliance leadership.
Pretty much done now here. Talk to her real quick. Okay, so that's where I'm gonna stop for tonight, guys. I appreciate y'all viewing my videos. As always, please subscribe and like my YouTube videos. And until next time, guys. See you later. Bye. Welcome back, everyone, to DelCast Gaming. This is Eric, your host, with Final Fantasy XIV Realm Reborn. This is going to be Episode 9, Part 2. I was just trying to get to the next part of the story. I got a pretty long way before I get to Heaven's Ward, but I'll try my best. So there's a lot of dungeons I still gotta finish up, and a lot of the end game that I gotta do. I still haven't finished the last dungeon yet for the main quest. That's what I'm working on. So let's continue forward. And as always, guys, just support my channel. Continue to support my channel by subscribing to it and also liking my YouTube videos. You can subscribe to Twitch or to YouTube. It doesn't matter. All right, so I'm going to be reading because I am actually playing and watching the videos for this game so I can kind of remember how everything went. And hopefully I can build it up to Dawn Trail. Tell me what I need to do that for. So, just trying to continue the story. I finished the job quest as far as I could for Realm Reborn, so that's pretty much over. That's the main guy for that. As you can see, we're wearing somewhat similar clothing. No, slightly different, but it's basically the same.
Same ground.
Van Belsar's demands are clear.
Well, I'm not surprised. This is what happens when the house gets desperate.
Alas, our minds are not.
I've never been one to shy from a fight, but if this weapon of theirs can do all they claim.
It has been 5 years since the calamity. And our people have scarce begun to rebuild their lives. Can we now, in good conscience, call upon them to risk what little they have left? Conflict, I say, though that would imply forces set in opposition. If the combined might of three primals could not stay Garlemald's new terror, what meaningful resistance can we offer? We who struggle to quell the foes who rise up within our own borders.
Long have we fought the primals. Are we to play this profitless game for the rest of days? I, for one, grow tired of it. Mistake me not. I do not propose to trade one tyranny for another. I love liberty. But conciliation need not mean oppression.
By the 12, though neither of you cried surrender, your every word betokened it. Not that I deny there is truth in what you say, nor can I rightly claim that Uldah is ready to fight. Refugees flood our gates, and beastmen swarm our land, while the great and the good do nothing. My flames struggle to bear the burden. I put on a grand show at the Remembrance Service, made all manner of lofty promises. I've made good on not a bloody one.
Do not blame yourself, Rauban. You said only that which the people needed to hear. All present have done the same. Our citizens had become lost to hope. If our words serve to kindle it in them anew, better we speak than remain silent. Our enemy condemns us for failing our people. Yet what does he care for their well-being? While we labored to rebuild their lives, the Black Wolf built instruments of murder with which to end them.
Her Majesty speaks true. For all our failings, the people's well-being has ever been our foremost priority. While none among us ever doubted that the Empire would one day resume its war, we scarcely had means enough to solve the problems of the present.
Aye, which is why we look to others to safeguard our future, the Scions of the Seventh Dawn. Alas, they are gone, and the Black Wolf is at our door.
Admiral! I fear you are mistaken.
Alphinord, Minfilia, and Seven Hells, Master Garland?
And you, dear friend?
By Ralga, you're alive. All of you.
As we approached, I would swear I heard talk of surrender. But I know that cannot be. It is not the Eorzean way.
Hear me, my friends. Accepting the Galleon's offer to vanquish the Primals would be folly. Folly, I say. For might is not the answer to the Primal threat. Indeed, the more the Empire exerts its strength, the worse matters will become. Primals enter this world when mortals call upon them, and mortals are wont to appeal to a higher power when they are desperate. Nothing is more certain to breed desperation in the Beast Tribes than the Galleon's proposed solution.
The true answer lies in a lasting peace, but the Galleons only know war and conquest. Should Eorzea fall into their hands, there will be such suffering as none can imagine.
We are not blind to the many challenges that each of your nations face. Yet you must not give in.
Aye. Remember 5 years ago when you wagered all for the sake of the realm? Remember what you fought for. Let the memories rekindle the fire in your heart, for Eorzea has need of it again.
Come what may, we Scions will never give up the fight. And so I bid you stand with us, and together we shall safeguard the future of the realm.
A great man once said that a shrewd merchant grasps not for the quick profit, but invests in the future. Wise words, eh, Rauban?
Sid, I...
Your words stir and shame me in equal measure. How could I contemplate surrender? I know full well that all we have, we owe to the sacrifices of those who went before us. We Gridanians have no love for war, yet we have still less for those who would threaten our homeland. Gridania will go to war. We will fight the Empire for the sake of the realm and all who abide here.
One homeland. The thought of losing another had blunted my resolve. But no man knows better than I that if you want aught, you'd best be ready to die for it. With great danger comes the chance for great glory and great profit. We old dons who have turned sand into gold know this well. How many times have we fallen into the pit of despair, only to have you pluck us out? I've fair lost count.
Reckless, the lot of you, like bloody pirates. Well, I won't waste my breath trying to talk you round. On account of being a pirate myself. And the pirate who shrinks from a challenge is no pirate at all. Those who would pick a quarrel with us must choose. Back down or go down with all hands. Let the Galleons come. The united strength of Limsa Lominsa will be waiting for them.
If our realm is to be free of this pall of darkness, let it be by our own hands.
For Eorzea!
We must needs consider how the weapon may be brought to bear against us.
The Maelstrom will secure strategic points along the coastline.
In the meantime, the flames will deploy at...
Be at ease, my friends. You have banished our doubts. Pray leave the military matters to us and retire to the Waking Sands. We will send word anon.
Make it to Limsa for a second.
Like
To the story, I guess. So I just had to get some stuff done. Check on that. Sorry. Everybody's here, looks like.
I cannot well express my relief.
So
to think that the
on.
Alliance yeah. came so close to surrender.
But the fire in their hearts has been rekindled, and they will fight to the last.
This warmth inside. Did you feel it too, Grandfather? I would know something. Was that your power at work earlier?
Nothing of the sort. The leaders of Eorzea had lost their way. I merely helped them to find it again. Oh, hello. Yes, our party returned just a moment ago. How close are you? It's all right, Cid.
We must needs plan our next move. Pray continue liaising with your respective nations. Cid, would you be our man in Ulda?
I'll be whatever and wherever you need me to be.
We haven't a moment to waste. All right! Let's do this!
Thancred's fate weighs heavy on my mind. I cannot bear to think of him enthralled to an Ascian. Mayhap you know this already, but the Ascians are immortal beings without physical form. Since time immemorial, they have fanned the flames of chaos from the shadows. That they might work unseen, the Ascians entrap and possess mortal men by means of malign artifacts known as Crystals of Darkness. One such crystal may yet be the key to saving Thancred.
This is a Crystal of Darkness.
A mere replica, created using data obtained from anomalous crystals found across Eorzea.
It comes to us courtesy of the students of Baldessian, our distant allies. Even for an Archon, Thancred's talents are exceptional. We all had complete confidence in him. It was for this reason that none among us foresaw the danger in sending him to investigate the Asians alone.
Thancred had been striving to fill the void left by Louis-Soir. Yet, it was plain that he was overtaxing himself.
Yeah. He would volunteer for everything and work till he was dizzy.
And the toll taken by his exertions made him vulnerable to Asian influence.
The crystal that binds Thancred must be somewhere on his person. If we could but destroy it, his Asian possessor would be compelled to relinquish control over him. You have proven the stoutest of allies, standing with us through thick and thin. Yet the most perilous struggle is still to come. For the sake of the realm and Thancred, I ask that you lend us your strength once more. Thank you, from the bottom of my heart. As I am sure you are aware, the realm was saved from certain doom 5 years ago by heroes known as the Warriors of Light. What you may not be aware of is that your many feats in service to the Scions have prompted folk to make certain comparisons. I must confess, you do remind me of them. Yet remember this, however glorious the past, it is the hero's lot to be judged on the deeds of the present. A new darkness threatens the realm, and the people cry out for a savior. I believe that you are he, a warrior of light, here in the present, guided by the crystal's will. Come, my friends, let us fight to safeguard the future of our beloved Eorzea.
Thank you. I shot him first. What? I did it a red shot on.
I can't even watch this. I don't know what's going on with that. The map doesn't help me.
The last one's gonna go crazy, right? No, because I've seen
those. Oh, yeah?
That's a guy's voice.
That one?
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's a guy's voice. So I gotta penetrate the Essien, the Garleans. Alrighty, went through all these little guys through here. I gotta fight some big boss in here. Don't better fight any of them. I just had to run around. It's always nighttime here. See, I think I lost the first time I played and the first time I came through here. But I'll try not to get killed this time. Set a little bit more comfortable here. Thank you. bruh. First times. A lot of running around here. I got killed by that stupid bomb. Very easy, so that way I can get out of here. I died last time I did this because those AoEs suck. Can't believe I got killed by that stupid jet. hopefully I can defeat him this time. I'm pretty sure I can this time. That time I got him. Thank goodness. He's a tough nugget. I don't know what happened there. I'll be right back, guys. I'm back. Sorry about that. Just need to snack on something nice and cold. Get this microphone out of my way for a little bit. That's good. after eating that popsicle. It's really good. It's like lime. It's really delicious. Get rid of these two characters first. They're gonna fight Odin, I believe. That's what it looks like to me. I'm about to fight Odin. Odin is a primal that lives in these woods. Very tough nugget too. See if there's anything I can do over here. Or that I need to do over here, like any story stuff. Not yet, okay. Just making sure. You never know. Quarry. I'm gonna try to see if I can fight Odin. Odin is pretty cool. I like Odin. He's like, reminds me a lot of the Dark Knight because, you know, darkness. I'm gonna do all these fights, except for extremes. I'll try not to do extremes, they're difficult. You have to have a good player to continue with that. up. Fast travel back, so that way I don't have to spend so much time running all the way back there. Playing for an hour already? Jesus, I don't feel like I've been playing for an hour. I'm hoping there's these guys up here, because, yep, okay, so I was kind of like confused there for a second. I was like, I know there's here, and it's up here. getting that dungeon now too, so it's nice. A little quest over there. I think I'm gonna go ahead and activate it while I'm here. Something for my gear, I think, if I remember correctly. I could be wrong, but I believe it's like binding my cracked materia to something for my weapons, I believe. My gear. Head on over to Blue Fog or whatever it's called. Since I've gotten this game, gotten this far. Can't see what's on my collar because of my gear, so I'm fine with that. Coffee, let's see what kind of weapon I get. Slightly better weapon, gear, I guess. It's a little better of a sword. I like this sword better, honestly. The shield is not as nice as the one I just had, but it'll work for what I need it, I guess. No, no thanks. Because they call it blue fog because it looks like blue around here. Then I'm going to the next crystal. Wait, I don't need to take a grass that crystal yet. Better do that right now. I mean, I could have, but I don't remember doing it, so I might not have done it. I don't remember doing it, but who knows, might have done it without thinking. Let me kill these enemies. I'm just looking for hunt log enemies right now. Right before the dungeon started. Okay, so this is one of the end dungeons that you'll have to fight in. Okay, I remember this one. This one has a somewhat of a maze once you go into the actual building, but out here is pretty easy. A wondrous place.
Thank you.
Okay, here's the first mini boss. This is a pretty easy character here. This guy's gonna die pretty quickly, I think. There's not gonna be much left of him after this. Here's the maze area. I don't remember much of this. I've played it like once after I came in the first time since I've restarted the game. I don't really remember much of this dungeon. I only played it once since I came back, and I don't remember. So this will be the second time that I've played it. Oh, sheesh. Yeah, it should be easy. So I think there's like a lot of little tomberries, but they're yeah, there are different types of tomberries that are gonna start fighting. Should be an easy fight though. These tomberries is nothing like Final Fantasy XIII's tomberry at all, so we should be all right. getting wrecked, bro. He's getting wrecked. He's already half-life already. I died right at the last minute. That's the second time this happened to me, where I died like right as we killed him. See if I get any new gear by chance. I don't know. I doubt it though. I'm gonna be stuck with this gear, I'm pretty sure, for a long time. Alright guys, so for episode 9, this will be the end of the playthrough for Final Fantasy 14, Realm Reborn. Starting it back up on episode 10, hopefully we can get to the custom, whatever it's called, and defeat and fight the enemies for the last dungeon. Alright, so I'll see y'all soon on Final Fantasy 14. This is Eric signing off with DelCast Gaming, and I'll see y'all next one. Bye!